Hello everyone. Listen, if you can tell by the thumbnail, I'm gonna get right into it. To paint a picture, you're 16, 17 years old, you're in high school, and you wanna become a chef. Now, my number one recommendation is to start working in a restaurant, okay? Any level. Food runner, busboy, prep cook, dishwasher, these are all entry level positions. It'll be very easy for you to get your foot in the door. Now, let me explain why. I think what's really important is I see it all the time, and not so much anymore, but a lot of people look at what happens on Instagram, what happens on YouTube, and they see these food creators, you know, and they want to become a chef. But what they realize is that has nothing to do with the chef world. Now, if your goal is to be a YouTuber or a social media star, then or food blogger, then don't even waste your time. Just focus on that, and you can learn off YouTube and everybody else that's creating content. That's more of an influencer role. But here's the thing, if you actually want to be a chef and own your own restaurant one day, or work for a hotel, or work for a celebrity chef, or run restaurants, then you need to go work in a restaurant first. It's my number one suggestion. I know it's not everybody wants to hear that, but it's the truth. You will find out within a couple weeks whether you really want to work in the restaurant business or not. And here's the thing, you know, it doesn't matter what position you start at, okay? Because if you have zero experience, it's going to be very difficult for you to get a job in the kitchen, guarantee it. So everybody usually starts at a food runner, busboy, front of the house first, or prep cook, dishwasher, and then they move their way up. And there's nothing wrong with that, and that's honorable. And I think what's really important is taking consideration, like, you want to give it at least 3 to 6 months, right? Do the best you can. Just make sure you tell your manager or the chef that, hey, I want to be a chef. My goal is to be a chef. This is what I need to do. Now, do you need to jump into culinary school really quick? You know, honestly, it's a very touchy subject, and I am not going to sit here and tell people not to get to further their education. But what I can say and what I will say is it's almost not worth it nowadays. And the reason why I say that is because the return on investment is not there. And the fact that you leave culinary school at, 20, 21 years old with $60,000 to $150,000 in debt, you're already getting kicked in the teeth before you have a chance to get out in the world. Now, if you are able to get grants, or if your parents are helping you pay, or if you're getting subsidized, or you have some sort of coverage, whatever it is, if it's a tech school, you know, if the tuition's low, then by all means, do your thing. But I think what I want to try to tell the young and upcoming chef, that if you're in high school, if you're going to college, but you still want to be a chef, get a job and part-time in a restaurant. Trust me. Okay, because the benefit is you're so young, you can hop in there. If it's something that you really want to pursue, then guess what? Then you can start building blocks and foundation off of that. All right, let's take a step forward. Let's say you want to be a chef, right? This is what you want to do. You're super passionate about it. I knew I wanted to be a chef when I was 16 years old, okay? 14, I was dabbling, but at 16, I knew it. Something clicked in my head and said, you know what? I want to be a chef. This is what I want to do. Okay. It took 10 years minimum, actually a little bit more than 10 years till I got to a sous chef level. Okay. It took hard work. It took dedication. And so I'm going to be the first one to tell you, I don't want to sugarcoat anything. Depending on which direction you want to go, it's not an easy job. Okay. It's not a 9-to-5 desk job. Okay. This job is very labor intensive. It's long hours, long weekends, long nights. It's very, very difficult. Okay. But it is very rewarding. When I was growing up in the industry, being a cook was not really, something that was ideal for a career path. Okay. Nowadays it's changing. You know, chefs are celebrities. Chefs are in front of cameras now. You know, chefs are established in restaurants. They're actually making money. So I think that's really important to take note. It's not like it used to be. When I was growing up being a chef, it was a different story. And I'm very happy to see where it's come, because now chefs are rock stars. And there's so much different opportunities out there. So the next steps. It's very difficult when you're a young cook to figure out what type of chef do you want to be. I'm going to break it down for you really easily, okay? You have Michelin star chef, you have your fine dining chefs, you have your hotel chefs, you have your catering and private event chefs, you also have private chefing or estate chef, you also have yacht chefs. There's a bunch of different types of chefs, right? And I think what's really important is you need to dabble in a bunch of both, okay? Like, try a few things. Make a 5-year plan. You say, okay, during culinary school, I want to work at this. After culinary school, I want to be here. But the most important thing is you have to continue learning. Don't get stuck at one job and not be promoted in, you know, more than a year. I can't tell you enough. I think what's really important is to have a game plan, and if plans change, that's okay. But it's very difficult to pin down a cuisine. There's so many different types of cuisines. What has worked for me in my past is knowing a little bit of everything, right? French, Japanese, Chinese, the different sections of Chinese. American, I'm going to say, of course, but knowing a little bit of everything, including baking and pastry, will really set you apart from everybody else. All right, that set aside. Okay, you're still in, you're still hooked, you still want to be a chef. All right, now, when you take in consideration the amount of money, right? I think this is something that's not talked about enough. A lot of people ask me, how much money are you going to make as a chef? And this is very up and down. But I'm going to create another video just for that because it's its own topic on itself. I have a lot of experience in it from all different levels. But this video, I'm going to strictly keep to, you want to be a chef, what are the steps? All right, so those are the steps that's my advice. I strongly stand behind it. If you have any questions or comments, or if you want to add, please add them down in the comment section. I'll be sure to respond. I think this is really good. I want to get the conversation going. If you're a chef, please, if you have something to say or something I missed, hop in the comment section. All right. I made a video last week about knives, but I really, really, truly, deep down in my heart, as a chef, I want to help the younger generation of chefs have a fruitful career. Okay, I made some bad decisions on my way up that really affect me nowadays, especially now that I have kids and a wife. And, I'm not going to get into that, but, you know, I wasted a lot of time. The advice that I would give to somebody is very specific. You know, don't go work in a restaurant. Don't work in a hotel. No, hop in the field right away. Okay, jump right in. Don't waste any time. All you need to do is be 16 years old. And I'm telling you right now, it's the best thing to do. Don't worry about culinary school. Don't worry about getting a knife set. Don't worry about getting a chef uniform. Don't overthink it. Hop in the restaurant business. And I'm telling you right now, the reins on the restaurant operation will guide you to the promised land. And then the thing is there's so much good information out there that you will know. So the one last thing is, okay, what restaurant should I work at? Blah, blah, blah. So what I'm going to recommend is a restaurant group, not chain. Restaurant group that is chef driven, that is reputable, okay? Or you pick out the best restaurant in your area, okay, that has a chef driven menu. Very important, okay? Do not waste your time with anything else. You need to go to a reputable restaurant group that's chef driven. A good example of that is Danielle Blood's restaurant group, Thomas Keller's restaurant group, Charlie Palmer's restaurant group. I'm just naming the ones that I worked at. But you need to go to a restaurant group, the Michael Mina group. Restaurant group that is reputable. It might be tough to get a job there, but it's very important that you don't waste time going working at Chili's or Applebee's or Cheesecake Factory, any of those restaurants. Forget about those. Forget about fast food, okay? Do not do that. What you want to do is look in the best restaurant in your area. That could be a Chinese restaurant, Indian restaurant, doesn't matter. Make sure it's chef-driven, primarily chef-driven, okay? Very important. And then I think what's really important is to when you go to apply, right, you write as many emails as possible and you keep hammering away. Trust me, the squeaky wheel gets the grease, all right? Trust me. I know it sounds crazy, but if you walk into that door, don't ask them for an application. You say, hey, I want to speak to the chef, or hey, I want to speak to the manager, and tell them directly, here's my number, here's my name, make sure you're clean. Please give me a call. I'm looking to be a chef. I want to see what it's like to work in a restaurant business. I'm brand new. And trust me, it'll either work or it won't, but at least you tried. And I guarantee you, I would say there's a 60 to 75% chance you can get a job nowadays because of COVID and everything that's going down. Working is really easy. I know a lot of places that are looking for manual labor, to be honest. So one last thing that I want to say, and this is very important. Don't obsess about the next couple years. If you're in high school right now, if you're just starting college, listen, you got plenty of time, okay? There's no rush. You could literally do this for 5 to 6 years and start all over, and you're totally fine, okay? I remember having the perception that, oh my God, if I'm not a sous chef by now, oh my God, I'm never gonna make it, I'm never gonna get paid. That's okay, but I'm telling you right now, be patient. You have to be patient. Just because you're not a sous chef at 19 does not mean anything, okay? You have plenty of time. And trust me, I've seen a lot of people hop into being a chef and realize it's not what they want to do, and that's okay too. But it's good to find out earlier than later. What really sucks is if you go to culinary school without working in a restaurant, and culinary school's all fine and everything, but then you come out there with a culinary degree, you get plopped into a restaurant, which you will start at the bottom because you have no experience, and then guess what? You freaking hate it. I've seen that. I've seen that with my own eyes. I've seen it because it's grueling. So anyway, please, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, leave them down in the comment section. I would love to respond. This is just a freestyle video that I wanted to throw up. This is a common question that I get. And listen, if you have any other questions or you want something me to answer specific, go over to my IG, okay? I'll leave a link down below. Okay, TikTok's a little crazy, but go over to my IG and leave a comment. Make sure you follow me over there. Leave a comment in one of my recent videos. I always check the comments. I don't check DMs too much, but I check the comments. I reply to comments a lot on IG. All right, cool. Make sure you hit that subscribe button.